interplanetary mission from the West Coast, and NASA's InSight, the first outer space robotic explorer to study the interior of Mars.
It's going to Mars to do the science, to make the measurements that scientifically and personally I've been waiting for over 30 years for.
I'm feeling amazing.
How do you feel?
It's pretty exciting, you know. So at NASA, we're always going out there into space to reveal new knowledge.
Years ago, I was in Paris for the launch of Mars 96. The launch was made. The insertion to Mars was not made. We fell and we went to the Pacific. And we had two seismometers on the mission. So, that time.
Yeah, now 23 years later, I mean, it looks like you're probably going to get there.
Yes, we have to land, we have to deploy, but we made one third of the
That's a big deal.
Mass. It's a big deal.
For the first time, we're going to put a seismometer on the surface of Mars.
So basically, we're taking Mars' heartbeat, we're using a seismometer. We're taking Mars temperature, we're using a heat probe. And then we just want to make sure that our Mars can walk in a straight line. We check wobble as well.
Instead of looking at the geology of the surface and the rocks and the mineralogy, looking at the atmosphere, looking at volcanoes, all that stuff is great.
So this is just the very first step of a long journey for InSight. We've got about 6.5 months before it gets there. So what are the next 6.5 months going to be like for the science team?
We're going to start, we actually start rehearsing operations starting in about a month. We have this whole deployments scenario that we have to go through. The instruments are on the deck. We need to put them on the ground, put them in a place that they can operate safely and effectively. And that whole process will take us two or three months. We have a mock-up of the InSight lander with an actual robot arm, which is a near copy of the one that's flying on InSight. And when we get to Mars, we're going to take pictures of the area in front of the lander in stereo, so we can make a 3D representation. And we're going to go into that test bed and actually mold the ground into the shape that we see on Mars. Put the rocks in the same place, you know, find rocks that are the same size and shape, maybe even 3D print some to get in there, and then we'll start practicing in real, you know, for the real case. But meanwhile, we have to know generally how it's going to behave in that area.